And I'm Kyle.
And we are with
Prairie Fire Children's Theater.
Now sit back, relax, and enjoy Sleeping Beauty.
Right. everybody. Let's not lose this mood, okay? Why don't we rehearse that dance number again? We've got to get it right one of these times, right?
Perfect timing, Mr. Director. I've got these gals all warmed up like biscuits. Dance biscuits. Okay, girls, remember what we worked on. Work, work, work. Feel the music inside your soul all the way down your gallbladder.
If you're quite finished, I'd like to start rehearsing. All right, roll audio.
Anything for the press, my dear. Anything at all.
So, Miss Love, I realize that
Well, she sure does that, theaters.
Yeah, but show business can be pretty fickle.
Well, technically with the money that we're paying her, we can hire 37 trained monkeys to type Hamlet.
So, what is the problem, Thomas?
Oh, the problem is...
The problem is that you have hired a complete imbecile to run your motion picture. The problem is that my daughter is being forced to work in conditions which are clearly beneath her. For instance, these sheep. Now, I am not saying that sheep are not useful animals. I myself have several blankets made from sheep. But to have these animals on a movie set is completely unacceptable. If my daughter is forced to commingle with those beasts, she will throw a fit. She's breaking out into hives.
Those poor bees.
Listen, Miss Alfredo, the sheep are not the problem.
Got the sheep signed to a two-picture deal, Mr. Alfredo. We're doing a sheep musical next.
Yeah, hopefully it'll be better than our last musical about cats.
Yeah, cats. Picture was a mistake. 2.5 hours of felines chasing yarn.
Listen, Mr. Alfredo, the problem isn't the sheep. All of our problems can be easily blamed on her. This picture is never going to get finished unless she is fired. I beg you, just please fire her already.
All right, I will grant you this one request. On this, the day of my daughter's wedding.
Mr. Alfredo, you don't have a daughter.
Yeah, you've never even been married.
You should consider both marriage and children, though, for the tax benefits, and let your first child be a masculine one.
You're fired, Mallory. Look, sorry. Nothing personal, just business.
Why, I've heard enough. You can't fire her because she quits! Now, come on, Pookie, let's make like a tree! Get out of here!
Oh, my goodness. What a scoop! Glamour Girl gone!
Well, now what are we going to do?
We don't have a replacement on the lot.
I keep telling you, we could always just hire those monkeys. I don't really care who we hire right now. Anyone is better than that Mallory.
Excuse me, sir. I've just got to clean this area here, and you're standing in the way.
You're perfect!
Excuse me?
You, kid. I'm gonna make you a star.
Mr. Alfredo, that isn't exactly what we have in mind.
Cannon, this is the most polite and breathtaking girl I've ever seen. I know talent, and she has it in space. She'll be your star, or you will be sleeping with the fishes.
And here we are, back on set, with the young star that has just been fired. And a complete unknown is about to be fed to the wolves. Should be interesting.
All right, kid, listen up. You seem nice enough, but you're going to have to prove yourself. We're just gonna plug you into this picture and hope that you don't screw it up too badly. Just watch them for the changes and try to keep up, okay?
I'll try my best. I'm still not sure about all of this.
All right, ladies, we got 2 new feet with us in this number, so let's try to be patient.
Okay, don't worry about messing this up. Don't think about the millions of people that might see you on the movie screen. Don't think about the millions of dollars that you would cost the studio if you were to mess this up. Just relax, okay?
Sure thing. Just remember to count. You know how to count, right?
Well...
Of course you do. It's easy as cake. Dear cake.
All right, if you're quite finished, you'd like to start?
Yes, sir, Mr. Director.
Hey, she's the assistant director and I'm the head of this roost. Cock-a-doodle-doo!
I'm still not really sure what to do.
All right, whatever. Roll camera.
Get down, please be asked, go scene 15, take 1.
Roll camera.
Roll audio.
Rolling audio.
Speed.
Action.
Continental Congress was that?
Well, I was busy counting, and then I kind of...
kind of went over here. Is everything okay?
Probably not. Obviously, this dance number needs more work. Let's just hope we have 10 years. Did you get a chance to read that script?
Script?
Great, all right. Let's just rehearse that scene again. We're gonna record you to see how you look on film. Here, take this. Just follow them for the changes, okay? Let's just rehearse that part of the scene.
Thanks. I just wish I knew what was going on.
Well, we're rehearsing a scene, and in this scene, you're trying to raise money to save your family's mill from the mustache guy over there.
His name's Eugene. Don't worry. He's a really nice guy.
Anyway, you've gone all your friends, and that's our chances to come up with a long show to raise money.
You'll be putting on a show in a barn where there's a bunch of sheep.
Sheep?
Yeah, and at the beginning of the scene, the constable comes over. You're eventually going to fall in love with the constable, but that's not until the end of the movie.
He's a brilliant actor. Bit of a diva.
Hey, where's my bowl of orange M&Ms?
Pretty soon you'll be tied up on a set of railroad tracks. Make sense?
Well, we'll see you later.
Bye.
Miss this gathering for all the cheese in Wisconsin.
Try all you want. This mill will be mine.
Hello, Constable. I wasn't sure if you were going to make it today.
Oh, my dear, I wouldn't miss this gathering for all the sand in Matoma.
Ha ha ha, try all you want. This mill will be mine before the week is up.
Now you listen here.
God, what are you doing?
I'm sorry, I thought he was supposed to ride it on his horse.
On his horse? He's standing right here. Oh, Mrs. Pointless, we're never going to get this picture finished.
I'm telling you guys, we gotta find some work soon. We just ate our last can of beans.
Fine with me, I hate beans.
Me too, why can't we ever get some real food?
Yeah, I could go for a little episode right about now.
And things are bad, guys.
How bad are they?
Well, things are so bad that unfortunately I don't know if I can keep you guys on staff much longer unless we find some work and quick.
Yoo-hoo! Anybody home?
Hey, quick, get respectable looking. Hello, my good lady. Zin R. Franklin, at your service. Charmed.
Indeed. I'm Coco Love, and this is my daughter, Mallory.
Have we met before?
I don't think so. I never forget a face. Although, in your case, I would be willing to make an exception.
It smells funny in here.
Sorry, we just did our last can of beans.
I heard through the grapevine that you're the kind of gentleman who might be useful if I wanted something done. Something not necessarily on the right side of the law, if you know what I mean.
I might be able to be of service. Hey, Dad, knock it off with that respectable bit. Listen, lady, you have no idea. We can handle any job you throw at us. Someone's up to no good. Will we hang around in your neighborhood? Give us a job, we'll stop the lane. We're up to something. Hey, you guys remember that time we fixed the 1919 World Series?
No!
Yeah, me neither.
I couldn't fix the radio to listen to it. Look both ways before you cross. We do evil deeds, we'll show you who's boss. Listen to us, it has a nice ring. We're up to something. But seriously, lady, anything you want done, we'll handle it. Robin?
Loitering.
Money laundering.
Underworld laundering.
Ew!
In the darkness, we always lurk to finish all of your dirty work. Here comes our favorite part to sing. We're So, what is it exactly that you need done?
There's this girl, see? And she's standing in between my girl and her shot at stardom.
Yeah, I'm going to be the biggest star under Orion's belt. So we need this girl out of the picture. Literally, you dig?
We don't want to do anything too rough, but if you could do something to make her fall asleep for a few days, that could give us all the time we need.
Oh, you want to make her fall asleep, do you? Well, I got just the thing.
Late morning on 4th of July, glorious, sunny, hot and hot, flags flying, drummers drumming.
Holy Hannah! We want to make her fall asleep, not make her comatose!
Okay, sure thing. They just leave everything to us. But you do understand that there will be a small fee.
Yeah, we're flat broke.
Yeah, this depression is making us really depressed.
We've only got one thing in this world!
No money!
Well, times being how they are, I suppose I could float a little scratch your way. If you are willing to achieve the results I'm looking for.
Sweet.
Not me.
All right, guys. We'll see you later. And remember, don't screw it up! What she said!
Get it. Hey, get around, guys. We pull this one little jab, and you know what we got?